The girl sent me this video with a request. Help me please identify insects that bite my husband. They don't bite me, even though we sleep in the same bed. My husband finds several bites every morning. Our 4-year-old child sleeps in the next room and he is not bitten either. And there is a next video with commentary attached. We filmed this today and this insect looks like it's already fed with blood. So these are bedbugs, nymphs. It is clear that they are still small, they are not adults, and indeed, in the first video the insect is hungry with an empty intestine, and in the second it is already after the bite, with a belly full of blood. And such a hungry bedbug is easier to identify than a fed one, because in the fed ones the abdomen stretches in length and the insect becomes longer rather than rounder. And bedbugs are known precisely for having a flat, rounded abdomen. So make no mistake, well-fed bedbugs can look like this, a bit atypical for bedbugs. But the most important thing to understand here is that bedbugs bite everyone in the bed or in the room indiscriminately. And the girl who sent me this video simply thinks that only her husband is being bitten because she doesn't find any bites on herself. But indeed, she does not find them because she is not sensitive to these bites. And it is a well-known fact that more than half of the total human population of the earth do not feel bedbugs' bites and do not see any traces after such bites. And bedbugs, of course, are very good in evolving such evolutionary features and learning to bite people like this without leaving any signs of bites in such a significant part of their victims. Such bites can remain without any symptoms at all. For example, this happened to me. I have no redness, no bumps, no itching at all after a bedbug's bites. For some other people, these symptoms may pass quickly within an hour or two and disappear before the person wakes up. Accordingly, after waking up, he or she will not see any bites on the body and will decide that he or she was not bitten. Keep this in mind when planning bedbug's elimination treatment. There is, specifically in the case of this girl, she must definitely look for bedbugs, including in the room where the child sleeps. Perhaps the child does not feel their bites and the parent thinks that parasites are not biting him, and he may be bitten without signs of the bites. Because of this, parents may think that there are no bedbugs in his room and will not treat them. But the parasites may be there, and after treatment in the parents' bedroom, they can safely get into it again from the children's room. That is, if you find bedbugs somewhere in the apartment, be sure to inspect all the rooms where people sleep. Bedbugs can be everywhere, even where they don't seem to bite anyone. And destroy them accordingly wherever you find them, so that you don't have to repeat disinfection later. If you are also bitten by some insects, which species you cannot identify, take a photo or video of them and send this media to me. I will try to identify your parasites. And you can also watch the video from a viewer about unusual bedbugs that breed in swallows' nests, get into apartments, even bite people, but do not reproduce here.